Sermon this morning I've entitled AS, short title. I don't know that I've ever seen a shorter title for a message than two letters. Well, that's this particular sermonette, the word as. And I would add to that, thinking that some words define for us the difference between life and death. And as, the word as, is one of those words, surprisingly enough. Some other words are conditional in that regard. One of the things we need to always remember is that carefully reading the words that God has given to us is very important. Acts chapter 17, verse 10, the brethren, it says, immediately sent away Paul and Silas by night into Berea. Now, the Bereans are well known for this particular scripture that comes from the book of Acts, who coming there went into the synagogue of the Jews, Paul and Silas. These were more noble, it says kind of parenthetically after that, these were more noble. Who is these? The Berean brethren were more noble than those in Thessalonica in that, here's why, in the book of Acts, which was written by Luke and Paul, as far as we know, in that they received the word with all readiness of mind and searched the scriptures daily, whether these things were so. So that's not only a compliment to the Bereans, but it's also an admonition to us that we should follow their example. Search the scriptures daily and determine whether or not the things that they were encountering were true. I want to establish in this sermonette the meaning of the importance of the two-letter word as, A-S. Luke chapter 4 and verse 4, here we find that Christ has been in a spiritual confrontation with Satan the devil. Christ has fasted for 40 days, and when he was at that point of weakness, Satan came and tried to attack him and offer him all kinds of things in order to get him to worship Satan, which, of course, Christ would not ever do. And based on that temptation from Satan the devil, Christ spoke these words. It is written, and we'll see before the day is over, where it is written, and some of the other places as well. Jesus answered and said, it is written. Now, he's not quoting the New Testament there. Why? Because the New Testament wasn't even read. It wasn't even written yet. It was going to be written in the future, but it would be 50 to 100 years before there was published scriptures from the New Testament. Jesus answered him, saying, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone. Now, the devil was offering him bread at the end of 40 days of fasting. But by every word of God. Every word. Now, this word we're talking about is a very small word. It's a two-letter word, but it says we are to live by it. Not only by it, but by every word of God. Let's look at what we call, what the world, especially the modern Christian world, has called the Lord's Prayer. Our Father which art in heaven, that's the way it starts. Hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it already was being done in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread and forgive us our trespasses. And there is this little two-letter word. Forgive us our trespasses as, a word to be carefully paid attention to. It tells us that we are going to receive something from God, and really a very great thing from God, if we do something ourselves. Forgive us our trespasses, or forgive us our debts, as rendered in the old KJV. Give us our debts as we forgive those who trespass against us, as we forgive our debtors. Now, that sort of sets up something here for us that we have to look at. We don't receive anything more than we are willing to give others. It says, forgive us. Now, we have to be forgiven if we're going to have eternal life, don't we? If we cannot be forgiven by God, we will not receive eternal life. It says, forgive us. And that's one of the cardinal things that we're to ask for, as we're instructed in the Lord's Prayer. Forgive us our trespasses as, and I would add only as, because that's what's implied here, and we're going to read down below where we're reading now that is indeed what Christ says in his addendum. Forgive us our debts. Forgive us our trespasses. Forgive us our sins as we forgive others. That's in Matthew chapter 6 and verse 12. Of course, the whole prayer's there. But I just select this one line out because it has a word. And the purpose in the sermonette was to look at this word and to establish the meaning of it and the importance of the word as, so that we will follow that. Because it is an admonition to us that we must forgive others in the way that we want to be forgiven. Forgive us as we forgive others. You drop down to Matthew chapter 6 and verse 14. If you forgive men their trespasses, Matthew 6 and verse 14, your heavenly Father will forgive you of yours. If. That's another two-letter word, isn't it? I could have entitled this sermonette, If. If you forgive men their trespasses, your Father will forgive you also. Forgive us our trespasses. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who trespass against us. We're not entitled to ask for any more than that. What you give to the people who may have crossed your path is something that you're entitled to ask for if you have extended it. By the way, I think this is more than just about forgiveness of our sins, because I've noticed over the years that God has that same characteristic in our generosity. If we are generous to other people, God will be generous to us. And I've seen examples of people who were generous to others, and God was generous to them. You see, that's very consistent with what's said here about forgiveness of sins and our forgiveness toward other people. But, verse 15, here's the but. That's a three-letter word. You know, we have as and if, two-letter words. Here's the three-letter word, but if you do not forgive men their trespasses, neither will your Father forgive you yours. Is it important? That's a pretty impactful statement, isn't it? And, of course, there always seems to be some people who want to put conditional demands on someone who may have done them wrong in some way, or at least they perceive. Oftentimes they're not really correct about it, but they may perceive that someone has done something wrong to them. Well, I'll forgive them if they will apologize to me. You know what? I don't hope that God's going to forgive. If I set that kind of condition on somebody else, and I have all kinds of things that I haven't gone to God with and apologized for, if I'm putting that kind of condition on my forgiveness, I read that verse of Scripture. If you don't forgive men their trespasses, and in the way that you will forgive them, in the conditions that you set, you may expect that you will be given the same kind of forgiveness as you have given to other people. Or if someone would say, I'll forgive that person completely if he repairs all the damage. I don't think that I'm in hopes that God is going to set that condition on me, because there's a lot of damage I've done going way back to when I was a little boy. You know, and I can't repair all that damage. If I make my forgiveness conditional, if I'm reading this correctly, things will not go so well for me. Here's the conclusion. Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word of God. The word as is a very important little word.